Hi friends! Today let's dive into the first Hunger Games book and movie. Foxface is the nickname that Katniss gives to the girl from District 5 in her first games. The girl is redheaded and sly and elusive, which reminds Katniss of a fox.
The rest will be individual training.
We don't know much about Foxface. We know that she's from District 5 and that she gets a 5 in her training score. Fun fact, she's one of the few tributes who gets a score that matches her district number. The only things that Katniss notes about Foxface is that she's slender, quiet, she keeps to herself, and she's amazingly good at recognizing edible and toxic plants. Which is weird because Foxface dies by accidentally eating the poisonous nightlock berries.
I never even knew she was following me.
She's clever.
What if it wasn't an accident? Nightlock berries are extremely well known. We know for sure that they grow in District 11 because Rue recognizes them. They grow in District 12 because Katniss's father taught her about them. And we know that the capital and District 13 have access to them, though whether the berries grow there is unknown.
That's nightlock, Peter! You'll be dead in a minute!
Such a widespread and deadly berry would definitely be on the toxic versus edible plant station, the station that Foxface spent most of her time at and where she excelled. So, it's pretty hard to assume that she had never heard of nightlock berries. The question now is, why would Foxface kill herself? The point of the games, at least for the tributes, is to win, to go back to your family and friends as a victor, and to bring riches and food to your district. Let's look at the conditions that Foxface was facing in these games. We know she has no weapons and has been stealing food from the pyramid the couriers had. So, when Katniss blows up the pyramid, not only do the couriers lose their food source, but so does Foxface. Without any weapons, she won't be able to hunt, so she can only feed herself by gathering any plants she finds. With a score of 5 in training, she likely doesn't have any sponsors. And because her strategy relied on her being alone and elusive, she doesn't have any allies. The boy from her district is also dead, so she can't hope to ally with him so that they can get home together after the rule change.
Attention, tributes, attention. The regulations requiring a single victor have been suspended. From now on, 2 victors may be crowned if both originate from the same district. This will be the only announcement.
Before her death, the people she's left with in the arena are Katniss, Peter, Kato, and, in the movie, Thresh. Thanks to the rule change that I mentioned earlier on, Peter and Katniss are in a very strong alliance because they can go home together if they win. They have weapons, and Katniss knows how to hunt very successfully. Peter got a score of 8 in his training, and Katniss got a score of 11, which means not only are they dangerous, but they also have sponsors. Kato was part of the career pack, which means he is one of the stronger tributes.
Where did you go, Jawfire?
You got her!
Owe me 70, would you?
That's not gonna help you up there, Kato!
He has several weapons and is likely able to hunt to a certain degree. He got a training score of 10, which means he likely also is getting help from sponsors. Having had allies until quite recently, Kato won't be as tired as Foxface, as they could split up night watches, hunting duties, etc, etc.
Okay. Somebody make a fire.
When Katniss sees Thresh in the arena several days after the games began, she notes that he looks even stronger and buffer than before the games.
Just this time, 12. For Rue.
This shows that he has an abundance of food, and we know that he has weapons and superior strength. Having received a score of 9 or 10, depending on if you're following the book or the movie, he likely is also getting some help from sponsors at this point. This leaves Foxface in an arena of well-fed, well-armed tributes who are smart enough to have lasted this long. Foxface is incredibly smart and has probably figured out at this point she's not likely to win. She has very little food, and considering that she's only eating plants, she can't outlast the other tributes who are eating meat. She is also not strong enough or armed enough to fight them. Either she starves to death, she fights them and dies bloody, or she dies on her own terms and in a much more peaceful way.
I never even knew she was following me.
Through her training at the training center and what she learned at the plant station, Foxface knows the nightlock berries are incredibly poisonous. She realizes that she can eat these berries and be done with the games. She also knows that by dying like this, she's sparing her family and friends who are watching her back home the pain of watching her die in agony. She refused to let the games control the manner of her death, and she chose to die on her own terms. What would you have done in Foxface's situation? Would you have taken your chances against the other tributes? Please tell me in the comment section down below. If you want to see any of the other videos I've done, you can click here to watch a theory about Plutarch, or you can click here to watch a theory about Prim. Please leave a like if you enjoyed, and I hope you consider subscribing. Until next time, happy bubbles!